During a fishing trip as a boy, an accident left Edward O. Wilson partially blind. He then turned the attention of his working eye to the ground, crowded with tiny creatures that ignited his passion for nature. He would grow up to become a world-famous expert on ants and other insects, but we will always remember him for something else. His unique observations unraveled a hidden law of the Earth's ecosystems. As a young adult, Wilson embarked on a journey to study ants around the world. He noticed a pattern. Everywhere he went, small islands had fewer species than large islands. Wilson was intrigued by this finding, and he looked for a scientific explanation, together with ecologist Robert MacArthur. Their main premise was that large islands can hold a great variety of life, because creatures living there are less likely to go extinct, while smaller islands have more fragile ecosystems. To test that theory, Wilson's team selected four small mangrove islets for an experiment. First, they registered all the arthropod species, and then they fumigated the islets to wipe out all the creatures, something that would be impossible to do today. They later returned periodically to count how many insect species had recolonized the mangroves. 2 years later, the islets had regained a similar quantity of species as they had before the experiment. But the variety of these species depended on isolation. Life flourished on big islands, or those closest to the mainland, while smaller and more distant islands had less biodiversity. As the biologists suspected, size wasn't everything. They observed that islands closest to the mainland frequently received new individuals, which rescued the population from extinction, while more remote territories received little immigration. Scientists immediately grasped the importance of Wilson's findings. In nature, ecosystems like lakes or mountaintops also work as islands. But more importantly, this also applies to shrinking natural habitats that are isolated by human civilization. It also inspired the creation of wildlife corridors designed to connect protected areas that were isolated. In North America, for example, an interconnected system of wildland stretching 2,000 miles from Yellowstone to the Yukon region allows free movement of wolves, lynx, and grizzly bears, helping avoid their extinction. Thanks to Edward O. Wilson, science took a great leap forward in preserving the richness of life on Earth.